psychics, snakes, and cash. Tonight, a woman who used to live in Palm Beach County faces felony grand theft charges. Detectives say she tricked a woman, out of thousands of dollars by promising to remove evil spirits.
In this special report, investigative reporter Terri Parker confronted the alleged psychic and uncovered details on how the victim says she gained her trust and her life's savings.
It was in this North Palm Beach rented house where police say 23-year-old Priscilla Kelly Del Morrow tricked a woman into handing over her life savings, posing as a psychic named Gianna.
She knew exactly what she was doing. She had a game plan, and she did it very well to me.
She's too embarrassed to show her face on TV. We'll call her Kimmy. She says Del Morrow approached her at a mall, told her she knew she was having trouble, and convinced her to come over.
So I go to her house, and she tells me how I need these candles and these crystals, and they cost $150, and she had this menu.
But Kimmy says that was only the beginning. From $150 candles to $15,000 gold temples. Kimmy says Del Morrow convinced her she had to pay, according to the police report, up to $30,000 cash, all to get rid of evil spirits. And Kimmy couldn't tell anyone, or
somebody will get sick in your family, and then someone will die.
Answering to charges of grand theft, Del Morrow was in court Thursday. She has pleaded not guilty. I asked her about the charges after her hearing.
Would you like to comment on these allegations?
I'm not going to comment. I never did anything.
Kimmy maintains Del Morrow told her to bring $2,500 in cash, an egg, and a bag. Once there, she says Del Morrow lit candles and chanted. At the end of the chant, the candles all went out. And then Del Morrow smashed the egg inside of the bag and showed it to Kimmy.
And this was this crazy-looking snake in there, black snake. Obviously, I was so scared. I was ridiculously scared by that point.
I never took her money. Tell her to give me proof.
Well, she says you did the trick with the snake and the eggs. What's that all about?
Excuse me. Could you please go away from me, ma'am?
Snakes and eggs. It's a well-known scam that scared many other people into giving up their cash. Like Leroy Hoffert, the now-deceased 87-year-old Delray Beach man told me in 2002, that's one reason he gave over $300,000 to psychic Linda Marks to cure his leukemia. Marks was released from federal prison on fraud charges 2 years ago. This is her back in 2002.
But you are a real psychic, right?
Yes, I am.
Hoffert said Marks told him to put eggs under his bed and bring them to her.
She did put it in a saucer lake, and there were snakes.
In the egg?
Yeah, they were about that long. And progressively, they get shorter and shorter and shorter. But every time I went in there to do this, I had to bring money with me.
That day in 2002, we confronted Marks, who told us to leave.
Get out of my house.
And watch what her husband did as we shot video from the sidewalk.
You're the one. Off my property, or I'll call the police department.
Call them. We're not on your property.
Okay. What do you?
Hey, buddy.
As far as Kimmy, she says she was so frightened after the snake trick, she took Del Morrow to her house and handed her $25,000 more cash. Del Morrow told her she'd get the money back after she cleansed it. It was a few hours later, Kimmy realized what had happened.
I'm like, oh my God, what did I just do? What did I just do?
Now she says you tricked her. You told her that you were going to cleanse her money. You took almost 30.
She's a liar.
Kimmy went back to Del Morrow's house.
So she says, it's Christmas Eve, darling. How am I going to get your money now, darling?
And the next day?
The victim went back to confront the suspect. I mean, she vanished and with the money and the personal belongings that she convinced the victim to give to her, too.
Detective Adam Fox tried to track down Del Morrow. The rented house was abandoned. The cash was gone.
This one, to me, definitely appeared criminal because nothing was done. I mean, there were promises made by the suspect, and she didn't fulfill any of them at all.
Fox put out a warrant for Del Morrow, who was also wanted in Broward County on a charge of using fake receipts to return merchandise. In February, Del Morrow turned herself in to the Broward County Jail and was released on bond. Thursday, she appeared in court with a private attorney.
But did you take her money?
No, I never took her money.
Then what happened to her money?
Tell her to ask her. She never had that money.
I really hope that she learns her lesson really hard because she hurt me so bad.
The victim says that Del Morrow also convinced her to give her her Gucci purse and all of her jewelry. The police report says that Del Moro used fear and intimidation to get those items as well as the $30,000 in cash, and that Del Moro never delivered on the promised services or the artifacts she claimed would help the victim. Terri Parker, WPBF 25.